Hello friends, welcome to Math for Juniors. I'm Miss Marks and here is my assistant Snail.
Hello friends.
Someone is looking happy.
Oh yeah, I am happy, Miss Marks.
Not hard to see that. It's written all over your face.
I might get a chance to go to Paris next February. Do I need any more reason to be happy?
Well, that's a reason to be happy, but how come you got the chance?
I entered for a contest when I was at the mall. The winning prize is a ticket to Paris. That's why I spent rupees 100 on it.
Oh, that way.
Miss Marks, it is possible for me to win, nah?
Yes, it is. But see, Snail, a lot of people from all over the country will be buying it. Even if there are 10,000 such people, you will have very little chances to win the prize.
Oh, that's sad. Then what are the circumstances which favor my winning, Miss Marks?
Well, for that, you first need to understand the concept of total outcomes and favorable outcomes. So, let's get into the virtual world to learn about them. Consider an experiment of rolling a dice. The number of possible outcomes in such an experiment are 6. The outcomes correspond to the 6 faces of the dice. Let E be an event of getting an odd number. The outcomes 1, 3, and 5 satisfy the condition of getting an odd number in the experiment of rolling a dice. Such outcomes which satisfy a given condition are called favorable outcomes. Let's look at another example to understand in detail the concept of favorable outcomes. Consider an experiment of drawing a red ball from a basket containing 6 red and 4 green balls. The number of possible outcomes for the experiment is 10. If E be an event of getting a red ball, then there are 6 favorable outcomes satisfying the given condition since the basket contains 6 red balls. So, Snail, now can you tell me how many outcomes are favorable to the event of you winning that lottery?
Please give me a little clue, Miss Marks.
See, all the tickets will be put together and out of that, only one ticket will be drawn to find the lucky winner. How many tickets in those belong to you?
I have one ticket. So, there is one favorable outcome?
Yes, and the number of possible outcomes are the number of total tickets sold all over.
Oh, so you were right. My chances of winning are just negligible.
True. But the probability of winning is not zero, Snail.
Then, how much is it, Miss Marks?
Well, you will find it yourself, Snail. So, let's first learn to calculate the probability in the virtual world. Concept of probability can be introduced after learning about favorable outcomes of an event and the total possible outcomes of an experiment. Probability is the measure of how likely the event will occur. For example, in the experiment of drawing a red ball from a basket, the chance of getting a red ball is 6 upon 10, where 6 represents the number of outcomes favorable to the event of drawing a red ball and 10 represents the total outcomes of the experiment. This helps us to generalize that if the sample space of an experiment contains n possible outcomes out of which m are favorable to the event E, then the probability of event E is given by the number of favorable outcomes for E, that is m upon the number of possible outcomes, that is n.
So, Miss Marks, my probability of winning will be just 1 upon 10,000. Which is 0.0001.
Oh, Snail, that's right. But don't be sad. You have solved one problem. Now, Snail, to make you happy, I have an activity for you. It's very simple. Look at this spin board. Can you tell me what will be the probability of getting red? once I spin it?
Oh, that's an easy one. There are four possible outcomes and the chance of getting red is 1. So the probability is 1/4.
You're absolutely right. What about the other colors?
For other color also, the probability will be 1/4 only.
Well done, Snail. You know what? Equal probability implies that all these colors are equally likely to appear.
What does that mean, Miss Marks?
Well, let's understand that in the virtual world. Let's discuss a single coin toss and an event A of getting a tail. How do we determine the probability of such an event? The probability of such an event can be determined by using a formula. The probability that an event A will happen equals the number of favorable outcomes of the event A divided by the total number of outcomes. Here, number of favorable outcomes for the event A equals 1. The total number of outcomes is 2, that is, a head and a tail. Therefore, probability of the event A is 1/2. Now, notice that the probability of the event B of getting a head is also equal to 1/2. Therefore, events A and B have the same probability or they are equally probable. And as this is easy to observe by tossing a coin, this result is consistent with reality. So we are back. Wasn't that fun, Snail?
Oh yes, it was.
You know what, Snail? Probability theory is closely associated with the game of cards.
Really? I love playing cards, especially shuffling. I enjoy a lot doing that.
You know why do we shuffle cards?
So as to randomize the deck of playing cards to ensure a fair game.
Good, Snail. So which technique of shuffling you use?
What? I thought there is only one way of doing that. More you shuffle, better it is.
No, Snail. You need to know much more. Let me tell you. Do you know that there are several techniques used to shuffle a deck of cards?
Really?
Yes, the two most popular kind of shuffles are the random riffle shuffle and the overhand shuffle.
What are they, Miss Marks?
Well, in the random riffle shuffle, the deck of cards is divided in two equal halves. The top half of the deck is placed in the left hand and cards are then alternatively interleaved from the left and the right hands, or from the right and left hands.
Oh, sounds complicated. So, how many times this must be done to ensure a fair game?
In 1992, Bayer and Dikanese showed that after 7 random riffle shuffles, every configuration is nearly equally likely. Shuffling more than this does not significantly increase the randomness.
What about the other technique?
The overhand shuffle is easy and is used by most people. In this, a small bunch of cards are removed from the top of a deck and placed in the opposite hand in reverse order.
Oh, I also use this to shuffle my cards.
All right, Snail, let's now do a quick recap. In this module, you have learned that the outcomes satisfying certain given conditions are called favorable outcomes. Total possible outcomes of an experiment constitute a sample space. Probability is the measure of how likely the event will occur. If a sample space of an experiment contains n possible outcomes, out of which m are favorable to an event E, then the probability of E is given by m/n. So don't be disheartened. You may still be going to Paris next February.
Yeah, maybe. But if I don't win the contest, then I will never buy any lottery ticket.
Oh, Snail. Though I am against such lotteries and wastage of money, but still, it's good to think positive.
Oh, Miss Marks, I don't understand you. Firstly, you teach me probability and dampen my spirits of winning by letting me know that chances are negligible, and then you give me hope.
It's good to be hopeful. So what will you do if you win?
Then maybe I could give one more chance to my luck and try for some lottery that has a winning prize as chocolates, candies, muffins, cookies, pastries.
But now let's bid everyone goodbye. See you guys later in another episode of Math for Juniors. Till then, take care.
Bye.